So here we are on October the 5th, and it's another 40-degree morning, and I came out to the Spirulina feeders, which draws off the hornets and yellow jackets, to see what's going on, and I find these sleepy European hornets and bald-faced hornets, and had some thoughts about that. Since they're cold and can't fly yet, maybe I should pick them up. See how that goes. And you'll notice, watch the abdomen there. She's going to squirt out her venom right there. And she's not happy, but she's somewhat incapacitated by the cold, so I thought it would be pretty much okay to pick her up here and get some close-up views and see how articulate their abdomen is to see if she could actually deliver a sting. I know you want to see this in slow motion. That's a lot of venom. She did not extend her stinger. Why? Because she couldn't find flesh to put it into. So they don't extend their stinger unless they can manipulate their abdomen around and get it into you. But they have the ability to hunt and fly by night. They can also spritz their venom, as you just saw. A lot of people question whether or not they could do that, so I'm glad to get it on camera just for you. The other thing is, the reason all these yellow jackets and these European hornets, bald-faced hornets, are pinging on my apiary landing boards is because I let my feeders run out. So this morning I went out and filled them up again. And one thing led to another. I decided to experiment and see if I could really just pick up European hornets. Maybe there's a safe way to grab them on their thorax. Now you're watching this thinking, man, Fred, you know what? That one was already hindered by the cold. She's not fully functioning. I'd like to see you try that with a European hornet that's ready to go, that has all her flight muscles warmed up. Well, I'm going to do that. Keep watching. So the other thing is here, look at all the yellow jackets. These are the small yellow jackets. And they're all coming to this feeder. Why would I feed them? Well, as I explained before, it draws them away from my apiary and giving them spirulina-loaded sugar syrup distracts them, keeps them away. Now there's our European hornet there that I had picked up and put down. She tried to climb up to get to these feeders, of course, to get carbohydrates, sugar syrup, to warm up and fly away, but she actually fell in. I had to pick her up and take her out. And all these little yellow jackets, you think I'd pick one of them up? Nah. But here is another European hornet. Largest hornet in North America. Of course, the Asian giant hornet has shown up in Washington State, but this is the state of Pennsylvania. We don't have those yet. So I'm going to have to experiment with this one. Ooh, here's another one flying in. So the morning's just getting going, about 40, 45 degrees, give or take, and when the sun hits, of course, things are warmer. So I am going to grab one of these and see if I can get a hold of the thorax there and see if they can bend their abdomen around and sting me. What do you think? Reach in here and maybe grab this one. Got to come up high and behind there. Just like sneaking up on a scuba diver. Come in and you're going to totally surprise her and she won't be able to fly off. So I'm thinking the thorax is the best area to grab. And nah, near miss. Let's follow her around though. She's scoping me out. She's flying little circles, staring me down. She's not scared. She's going right back to drinking. And the mix is 2-to-1 sugar syrup, 2 times sugar, 1 times water, and 2 full tablespoons of spirulina. Ooh, she's mad. I got her. There's no backing out. If you let go now, you're going to get stung. Watch her stinger. Oh, she put it right into my thumb there. And look at the big glob of venom. So she actually squirted venom out the end of her stinger first. Yeah, I know. I had to let her go. Sorry, was that rough? You probably wanted to see this in slow motion. Look how mad she is. She actually comes after me now. She even jumps on the camera. They have attitudes. I mean, what's the deal? All I did was pick her up. I didn't hurt her. Here she comes. Come right after me. Let's see the whole thing in slow motion again. So I grab her by the thorax. Her forelimbs are coming up. She's trying to grab me, get me off of her. She's really mad because she was mid-sip there on the spirulina syrup. Watch her abdomen and look at the stinger. She extends her stinger and primes it with venom. See the little glint of venom there underneath my thumb? She's trying to find a place to stick it in there. Still hasn't made contact yet, but you can see how long the stinger is too. There she is, she's feeling around, so their abdomen is very articulate. By grabbing the thorax, you don't really control the abdomen very well, and she's gonna sting me right in probably the best place, just underneath my thumbnail. There's another glint of venom being extruded there. And keep in mind, as we saw with the other specimen, they can squirt their venom into the air, they can fly at night, they can squirt it in your face. They're just a lot of fun all the way around. Look at that big drip of venom on the surface of my thumb. Now she finally did find a way to get it in, and she's going to stick her stinger right in under my thumbnail. Still holding on to that spirulina in her mouth, though. She's not letting that go. But so this demonstrates, is there really a safe way to pick up a European hornet if you want to just grab one? Well, maybe if they're cold and a 40 degree morning. But once they're warmed up and fully capable of flying and doing everything else they need to do, they can get that stinger into you. So I wanted to share that with you. Don't pick them up. Look how unhappy she is. Now what you're watching here is at 5% normal speed. So this all happens really fast, and I held on to this hornet for the full duration of the sting, because I wanted to see what goes on there. How bad is it to be stung by a European hornet? Well, let me tell you, this was no worse than being stung by a honeybee. Now, the amount of venom seems excessive there, and honeybees leave their venom sac behind. They leave the muscle behind that continues to pump venom even once the bee has detached from that. Wasps, on the other hand, have a smoother stinger like this one has, which can stick into you, and they can sting you multiple times, and in the end the wasp flies away unharmed. But what I did, see, I got back at her. I made her get rid of all of her venom resources, so she has to build that back up before she can sting anything else. So is that revenge? Not really. Am I harming the European hornet for those of you who are very concerned that any of these are harmed? No, I didn't hurt her at all. Although at the end of this, I might drop her kind of hard. But that's because she stung me in the thumb. But you picked her up. That's right, I did. Otherwise you wouldn't be able to see exactly how the mechanism works. And there it is. And again, I would not pick up the smaller yellow jackets because they're just hard to get a hold of, let's be honest. European hornet, nice and big, big thorax. There are a lot of queens that are just getting ready. They're taking on carbohydrates. They're trying to get ready to get through winter, just like the honeybees are, just like the smaller wasps are. Everyone is storing up. And because they're not social insects through winter, they have to store all their fats and resources in their bodies. Then they'll fly into the woods somewhere, and they'll dig into some humus underneath the bark on an old tree, something like that, and they'll winter over with the fat stores that they've accumulated this time of year in the month of October. Now watch the stinger. It's about to release here. Out it comes, and now I can let her go, and there's still a drip of venom on the surface of my thumb. And there you have it. Can you safely pick up a European hornet? No, you can't, unless she's frozen. So if you want a sore thumb, just grab one. Look at all these little yellow jackets drinking at the spirulina. The honeybees don't seem to care for it. Also, this stuff is very caustic tasting. I dip my finger in it, and it leaves a mark. It tastes bitter on the tongue. So here's this same hornet after I dropped her down. I don't know why she wasn't happy with me. Well, she comes right after my camera. What is her deal? I didn't hurt her. All I did was pick her up. lands on my lens, clambers up over the camera, tries to come after my face. So my advice to you is, if you want to see if they can sting, watch this video. Don't pick them up, don't try it on your own. And I appreciate that you took the time to watch it. Have a fantastic work week, the month of October, and I hope your honeybees are doing great. And if you want to distract wasps from your bee yard, set up a spirulina sugar syrup feeding station. Wasps and hornets come to it, honeybees don't. And you can also use it as trap bait if you like to trap them. Please do not pick up venomous insects without adequate protection.